loves me. 4 and 5, he's by my side. 6 and 7, he's the way to heaven. 8, 9, 10, he's singing again. I can always count on him. I can always count on Jesus. I can always count on Jesus.
Hi kids, it's Kyle, and I'm going on a hike today. I'm getting everything ready. I've got a hat here to shade me from the sun. I've got my water bottle to make sure I'm hydrated. And I've got a couple snacks here that I'm gonna need along the way. Hey, I've also got this map of the footpath, so I'm not gonna get lost. A footpath is another name for a trail, and I sure picked a good one. This is a perfect day for a hike. A beautiful, beautiful footpath. It's gonna be so much fun. Hey, I think I hear Willard.
Hi, Kyle. What are you doing today?
Oh, hi, Willard. I'm getting ready for a hike. I picked a great footpath, and I'm just getting all of my gear here ready.
Kyle, what's a footpath?
A footpath is a path that you walk on with your feet. Footpath.
Oh, you mean like a trail?
Yeah, exactly like a trail.
Well, you know, I don't have any feet, Kyle. I would have to call it a crawl path.
That's a good one, Willard. A crawl path.
Well, I hope you have a fun time on your hike, Kyle, but watch out for sticker bushes on the footpath. Those are always pokey and they hurt.
Oh no, there are no sticker bushes on this footpath because lots of people walk on it. It gets all worn and packed and nothing's gonna grow on it at all. Here's my map of the footpath. A picture of the footpath that I'm gonna be hiking on today. Why don't you take a look?
Oh, look, there's some people walking on the footpath.
Yeah, it looks like they're enjoying some exercise walking on that path. I can't wait to do that too.
Oh, I'd like to go on your hike with you, Kyle, but I don't have any feet. I think I would just slow you down. Would you take some pictures for me though?
Yeah, that's a great idea. Hey, wait, I've got a great idea here. The true story from the Bible today is about a footpath and some seed. Would you like to hear that story?
Oh, I would love to hear that story, Kyle.
Hey, great. Hey, you know what? Steve, our friend Steve, he's gonna tell us that story.
Oh, that sounds just super.
All right, here you go, Tweety. Here are some nice seeds for you to eat. Oh, hey, everyone. Hey, it's me, Steve. And I'm feeding my pet bird. He likes to eat seeds. And I like feeding him to them. I like feeding them to him. And sometimes he'll sing me a happy little song. Today I got a little Bible story that has some birds in it, too, actually. And I wonder if they're Tweety's cousins, maybe. Anyway, this story is called a parable that Jesus told. A parable is another name for a story. So one day, a farmer went out to plant some seeds, and as he scattered them across the field, some seeds fell on a footpath or really hard dirt, and the birds came down and ate them. So anyway, the explanation for what that parable is about is the seeds that fell on the footpath represent people who hear the Bible but don't understand it or don't do what it says. Then Satan comes and snatches away the seed that was planted in their hearts. Some of that is a little confusing, so I'll explain it a little more. In this story, the farmer is Jesus, and the seeds that he's planting is the Word of God. Do you know what the Word of God is? It's the Bible. The soil, or the dirt, that he plants the seed in is our hearts. If our hearts are soft, like good dirt, God's Word, the Bible, will grow in our hearts. But if our hearts are hard, like the footpath Kyle was walking on today, then the Bible can't grow in our hearts. What do you think about that Bible story, Tweety? I don't mind giving you seeds to eat, but you can't eat the seeds of the Bible that God's putting in my heart, so I need to really listen. I want them to grow. I think Tweety liked it. I hope you liked the story, too. Keep listening to the Bible and say yes to God. Why don't we all say that together, everyone? Say yes to God, and the truths of Jesus will keep growing in your heart too. One way that we can say yes to God is by reading our Bibles. Do you have a Bible? I like to read my Bible before I go to bed so that I learn how to be more like Jesus. We should say yes to God. Say that with me again, one more time. Say yes to God. Well, it was fun getting to see you all again. I'll see you next time. Bye!
That is a great story full of truth from the Bible. The farmer is Jesus. The seed he plants is the truths of the Bible, and the dirt is our heart.
Oh, I love Jesus and the Bible. I know a lot about dirt, and that's not good soft dirt you have there, Kyle. Yuck! I don't ever want my heart to get hard like that dirt.
Me either, Willard. But sometimes when we don't listen to the Bible and do what God wants us to do, our hearts start to get a little bit hard.
Oh no! What do we do when our hearts get hard towards God, Kyle?
We have to say yes to God. Let's say that together. Say yes to God. To say yes, we can pray and ask God to make our hearts soft again, and He will. Let me show you. Let's pray together about our hearts. Dear God, we thank you. We pray that you could come in our hearts and make them soft again. Amen. You see, Willard, when we pray, it's like God takes the hard dirt in our heart and He makes it good again, like this. Watch, let me show you.
Oh, really?
Yes, God loves us so much. He wants us to grow and be more like Him every day. If we ask God to help us, He will help us. We have to listen and do what He says. We have to say yes to God. Hey, let's say our one thing again together. Say yes to God.
Oh, Kyle, have you ever seen seeds grow under the ground?
No, Willard, I can't say that I have.
Oh, it's so cool. Do you want to see?
Yeah, that sounds awesome.
All right, hold on one second. Here, put these on.
Oh, wow, okay. Let's see if I can get these on over my hat.
All right, you look all ready. Let's go. Inside of a seed is a little plant just waiting to be grown. All it needs is some soft, warm soil and a shower where it was sown.
Down go the roots. Up sprouts the stem. Now leaves will follow them.
Plants in the soft soil grow to be strong. On that you can depend.
Don't let the seed drop on paths. It may spoil, or birds might snatch it away.
A seed needs sun. A seed needs soil. A seed needs a safe place to stay.
Inside of God's word is a little plant, just waiting to be grown. All it needs is a soft, warm heart, and its teachings start to grow.
Listen closely, say yes to God's word. In your heart, the seed will grow.
The seed is the Bible, the soil, your heart, and the farmer is Jesus, you know. That was so cool, Willard. I could watch that all day.
Yep, I actually do watch it all day sometimes.
I want God's word to continue to grow in my heart, like those plants.
Oh, me too. I want to make sure that I listen to God's word and try to be more like Jesus. I want my heart to be like good, soft soil.
Hey, Willard, I was just thinking about my hike. Would you like to come along with me?
I would, but remember, no feet. I would just slow you down, Kyle.
Well, I do have a little more room in my pack here. What do you think?
Oh, well then yes. Oh, I would love to go on your hike with you, Kyle.
Awesome, come on.